Here we have a little yellow-bellied slider. Oh, and a fantastic leech on its shell. Look at that leech.
Wow. They call this man Turtle Bob Walker.
This is a beauty, really pretty one.
This is, in fact, the only turtle we see today, as Bob and his dog Al show us around Nokuse Plantation. The plantation is a 55,000-acre restoration project purchased by businessman M.C. Davis starting in 2000. Davis had a 300-year plan that would end with mature longleaf forests grown over several lifetimes. Today, we'll see some of what's been accomplished over the first couple of decades.
We have something really great here. Here we have a gopher tortoise burrow. This tortoise is about this size, which means that it's about a sub-adult. It's not even adult yet. We haven't seen any adult burrows, but we've seen this sub-adult and then that juvenile, which is good.
Years ago, Nokuse Plantation relocated adult gopher tortoises to this restored sandhill habitat. But we're not finding any active adult burrows.
They're very difficult to relocate, so if they're not in that perfect spot they want to be, they will leave, and they'll find another area. And in this case, they laid eggs before they left, and the coyotes or the raccoons did not find them, and we had some actual success with the regeneration of the tortoises here. Here's an area that has that huckleberry. I see a couple blue ones.
Prescribed fire opens up the understory for tortoises and their food.
When we burn this, the wire grass starts coming up almost within the next couple of days. And the tortoises need food still, so that wire grass is important to the tortoises. This is one of our legumes, the galactea, which is a milk pea. That's very important to especially young gopher tortoises because that leaf is so tender. Gopher apple. It will produce a small whitish fruit about the size of a grape. And the gopher tortoises just absolutely love it. Here we have a little vaccinium.
Fire also opens up the understory for pollinator plants. Some provide nectar, others provide larval food for butterflies such as the zebra swallowtail and the monarch. So we can see that an open understory benefits plant and animal diversity, but it also allows water to pass through the sand, where it becomes a source for steephead ravine streams and seepage slopes. Those just happen to be our next two stops.
All right, let's run down.
Steepheads form in deep sand hills along rivers, carved by the water that collects beneath them.
This is a recent fall. You would just think there would be lots of frogs in here, right? Lots of snakes in here feeding on the frogs. And yet, we don't see anything. They're here. Nothing alive. But there was a deer down here at least at one time. There's the shad deer antler. That's a nice one. That's
yeah.
A good one.
Yeah.
It's an 8-pointer. He probably wants it. You want that? Take it. It's all yours, Al.
Between the cool, fast-flowing groundwater, shaded canopy, and the narrowness of the ravine, steepheads are a different kind of Florida landscape, and they're a haven for reptiles and amphibians, animals good at hiding in the muck.
What a perfect place for a cottonmouth just to hang out. You know, I mean, it really is. It's just so beautiful in here. It's just incredible. And they have decided to hide, although he hasn't even gotten bit. You wonder, how old is a steephead? How many years, how many millennia does it take for a steephead to grow by a quarter mile or by 100 feet or whatever, you know? Ready? Go.
Go. Let's go. Let's go.
The The same cool groundwater that seeps out and forms ravines creates another type of habitat here.
This is a seepage area where generally it's at least moist. Right now during our drought, it's a complete different type of soil, you know, and soil is still a little moist even though it's relatively dry. And because of it being a seepage, we have these different plants like the Sarracenia here, which is one of the pitcher plants. It's really amazing how these pitcher plants are growing, and they're not growing all in big clumps together. They're just spread out just as far as you can see, and probably on, I don't know, maybe 100 acres here. And so they have adapted to fire. And without fire, as you can see right here, you know, the tie and these different plants will start crowding out the pitcher plants. And they need that open sun. So when we burn it, it will burn through it and it'll open it up for these pitcher plants. They rely on fire.
Most of Nokuse Plantation is not open to the public. However, you can hike about 27 miles of the Florida Trail on the property, where you can see longleaf restoration in several stages. Nokuse also operates the E.O. Wilson Biophilia Center, where Turtle Bob can teach you about our native North Florida wildlife. For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.